beans, or shall I say, superstar film directors. I'm going to be doing a short tutorial just to show you a few simple tips on how to get the most out of your video functions on your phones if you feel like making some videos or some little short films that maybe we can all share together on our YouTube, our Facebook, keep our amazing community together. My first tip is the way that we hold our cameras, in this case our phones. Now, this is called landscape mode. Now this is a rectangle, as you can see, and it's on its side. So it's wide and it's short. And we can see what this looks like. It looks quite like a film, like a movie. That's kind of what movies are shot in this kind of style. We also have portrait mode. As you can see, this one is a rectangle as well, but it's long and thin. Okay, and we often use this one in our selfies. You can see how it looks quite different. Now, my tip for you would be to decide which one you want to use and stick with that one. Otherwise, it may look a bit strange, flopping and flapping around, might not cut together, might get a bit confusing. We'll like to keep it as one style, just throughout. My next tip is which camera we use. Now, most of our phones have two cameras. There's one on the back and there's one on the front. Now, the one on the back means that when we look out at something and we want to film it, so I'm looking over here and I can see on my screen what I'm filming and I'm looking at it. So that is what's in front of me. If I want to film myself, or something facing this way, I can use the mode on my camera. It's different for everyone, but there's a selfie mode, and it's often in a little square here, and suddenly, oh, it's like a mirror. So, we've got our mirror shot. Now, this is using the camera on the front of my phone, and that means when I want to take maybe films of myself, I'll use the front camera so I can see what it is I'm filming and still be filming this mirror image. Just like a mirror, so you can make sure you look really fabulous. My next tip is on framing. Now this is everything that's in our shot. When we point our camera at something, we are framing it, just like a picture frame that we got. Imagine you had an empty picture frame and you went around and you looked at stuff. Everything would be put in that frame. Now, when we have a camera, that's what we're doing. And as superstar directors, we decide everything that's in that frame. If we're filming ourselves and we want to show the person is smiling, do we want to film it like this, do you think? Or would it be better if we filmed it like this? Before, we couldn't see that I was smiling. And also, it looks kind of weird, but here we can see my whole face, and also the background looks a bit better. My, messy little space, but it looks better than the sort of the edge of the wall and the vent. So like painters, we are deciding everything that's in our frame. Now, here's another example. Here is actually a window frame. It's a frame within a frame. Now, we have a choice. Do we want it to be symmetrical, which means it looks both halves of the frame look the same? Do we want it to be at an angle? Do we want it to be high? Do we want it to be low? Do we want it to be wonky? Do we want it to be straight? There's lots of different ways that we can make really interesting, fun images that we have chosen. Now, unless you're trying to film yourself as if you're in an earthquake, it might be another useful tip to try and keep your camera very, very steady. Now, we can do this with our hand. Sometimes it can help to have both hands on the phone to keep it really, really steady. Now try to not get your fingers in front of the camera, because then, oh, hello, here you go, oh, look, I've got a finger for a face. That's a nice way to keep it nice and steady with both hands. And look, we can sort of like, it's quite fun, isn't it? Quite nice, quite like that. Just enjoying myself here. If you find it difficult to keep it steady, or you want a super steady shot which doesn't move at all, you can find somewhere safe and sturdy to prop your phone. So that could be a table or a shelf, but make sure that it's secure and it's steady, because we don't want your phones falling off anything. It's a good idea to make sure there's no loud background noise when you're making your video. Even if it's your favorite tune, if you want people to hear what you're saying, it's best not to have too much background noise. So that could be loud music, that could be a radio, a TV, it could be people talking, it could be some loud traffic if you're outside. So my final tip would be about light. If you're in a place that's too dark or a bit dingy, your viewers might not be able to see you properly and see all your amazing footage that you've been shooting. So I would recommend get some good light. That could be from a window, it could be if you're outside, it could be just from the regular light in your house. But try to make sure there's enough light so that we can see everything that you're doing. So that's our filming tutorial done. We really look forward to seeing some of your great videos, and happy shooting!